And the Christian have their role too, what they have to do. Nutzri, it means to keep. Limso, it means to keep. It is a verse in the book of Mishle, Notzer Te'ena, Yochal Piriyah, the one that keep the fig, he will enjoy it of eating the fruit. Veshomer Adonav Yechubad, and the one that guard his master, he will be respected. So, to keep the fig tree and to guard your master is the same thing. Right, so this is what Christianity do. Really, they keep something. Sometimes as a big dog that keep. it can be very dangerous. If somebody says something wrong about this, it can be very, very mean.
The keepers.
Yeah.
This was Christian do. They keep the fruit when the fruit is not yet ready to eat.
Not yet ripe.
In the moment the fruit is not ready to eat, have to be kept. And he, according to Jesus, even to he have to be even cursed, like he calls the fig tree because the fruit was not ready.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So Jesus not only he didn't add the tree of knowledge good and evil, what is the secret of the fig tree, from where we get the leaves to cover our neck to be when we was naked. Yeshua equal a room naked. It's why Jesus is a naked tree. Yeshua, with not the eye, equal a room, what it means naked. Right? So he's naked. So if you see a naked one, you have to cover him. To cover him, it means two opposite things. It means you cannot talk about it. You have to cover, to hide him. But you have to cover him, it means put clothes, it means vessel of what to talk about. Vessel of Torah, of the fig tree. The fig tree is the Torah. This is good, this is bad.
Evil.
Of course, the fig tree has to be connected to the tree of life, to the soul of the Torah. If not, knowledge that is not connected to the tree of life, just knowledge is not connected to life, it puts you in duality, in a place of, you just lost your harmony with your surround. But I cannot know by myself that this is bad when I'm not perfect. You put me in duality, good against evil, you know, it's, from the first place, the tree of knowledge, good and evil, put you in problem of half of you against the other half of you. It's not happen if the tree of knowledge, good and evil, is connected to the tree of life. Then even the curse, all the curse in the Torah, and the Torah is full of curse, it's all blessing, it's all one. The snake can be the Mashiach, just question of interpretation. Nachash, snake equal Mashiach in Gematria.
Oh, wow.
So I could see maybe what you're talking about, the snake on the pole
with Moshe,
where he became our sin.
Oh, the snake can heal you against the snake. Right, so it can be an imagined snake, it means our bad interpretation to the tree of knowledge, good and evil. Our bad interpretation, this becomes the world we live in it. Because everything we think this become finally the reality.
They say that if a poisonous snake bites you and you cut the head off of the snake and put the body on the bite, that it will draw the venom out so that you're not hurt by it, that it takes its poison back.
It's like homeopathy, I think, what you talk about, that you fight against the poison with the poison. You fight against the snake with the snake.
Yes.
All right, so it's one of the idea of in medicine. All right, so really, it's all one, the tree of knowledge and the tree of life. About both of them it is written that there was in the middle of the garden.
Makes sense.
All right, so God say you will eat from all the tree in the garden.
Just not that one.
Include, no. He say you will eat from all the tree in the garden. But if you eat the tree of knowledge, good and evil, you will die. It means he gives you something that you should know, that if you eat only the tree of knowledge, good and evil, separate from the tree of life, you will die. Right? So you have to be enough intelligent to do not separate.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you eat it alone, it causes death. But it is written you will eat from all the tree.
And you know, that makes me think of in Yochanan's revelation, in the book of Revelation, Yochanan, John, had a vision, and he says that those who keep the commandments, who keep the mitzvot, will enter into the gates and have the right to eat of the tree of life. So there's a direct connection between keeping the commandments and being able to eat from the tree of life.
Of course.
Because it's blessings.
But to eat the tree of life, it means to learn the deepness, the soul of the Torah.
Mm-hmm.
If not a fig tree, it's just a fig tree.
Wow.
What I care? And what I care if Netanyahu was under a fig tree or under another tree?
Mm-hmm.
Why is the sixth one? Maybe the sixth one is the tribe of Dan.
Which isn't mentioned.
What is a snake? If I count from Shimon, start with Shimon. Shimon is the second one in the order of birth. And the fifth one in the order of flag. In the two orders, Dan is the sixth one, starting from Shimon.
Mm.
So, still you are not a liar. It's why he says so. How you know me? I know you from the time you was under the fig tree.
Jesus is telling Nathanael.
It means, yeah. I know you from the time your soul was part of the snake. Still, you are not a liar. Now we know or understand why he says so. If no, it's just another story. So,
huh.
What I care? What is the Torah here?
Interesting.
Very interesting, yes.
You know, in the order of birth, after Shimon, you have Levi, Yehuda, Yisachar, Zvulun, Dan is the sixth one. In the order of flag, Shimon is the fifth one. After Shimon, we have Gad, after Ephraim. Ephraim, Menashe, Binyamin, Dan. Again, the two order, Dan, the snake, is the sixth one. Still, you are not a liar. Okay? So, and they ask him, when will be the second coming? So he said, like people said about the fig trees, that when they start to be ready, it means that the summer is close. Kites in Hebrew is like the same root letter like cats, what it means, the end of the day. So when the fig tree, but you kill the fig tree, doesn't matter if the fruit is ready, it means it's connected to the tree of life, the curse becomes a blessing. So then you can talk about Jesus. It's not a naked truth. Because in Christianity you have point. You have four points. You have the Trinity. It's three words in the New Testament. What is the Trinity? What we do with this? In the Christianity, nobody have any idea what is this teaching, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. What we do with this? Why is so important that all the Torah of Mashiach hiding there? And it is the body and the blood of Mashiach. What it is. We have only a ceremony that we keep something, but why is it so important? It's a point. It means it's just light. It's a light of chaos, we call it in the Hebrew tradition. And the coming of Mashiach, according to Hasidut and Kabbalah, is to take the light of chaos from the side of Asa, it means Christianity. It's a clean way to say Christianity.
What is?
Asa, the brother of Yaakov.
Oh.
Yeah,
in Kabbalah is related to what we call the light of chaos. his root is above Yaakov, that represents Olam HaTikkun, the world of rectification. World of rectification, it means that there are many vessels and the light is small.
Matzilut.
Above this, above Olam HaTzilut, it is Olam HaTov, where was the breaking of the vessel, because the light was too big and the vessel was too small.
Adam Kadmon?
Above Olam HaTzilut, related to the word below, Briya, Yetzirah, Siyah, called Adam Kadmon. If we talk only about Olam HaTzilut, so it's Ari Hanpin and Atik Yomin, it's what called the crown, what is above, the name of God. But it's related to a lot of light and small vessel. Above Yud Kevavke, it's like above the brand, above the end, above the two eyes, etc.
Duality.
Above the brain, it's like above consciousness,
mm-hmm.
It's the crown. So the crown is something that is not rectified there.
Keter.
The keter, it means if I'm not aware, I cannot fix it. But it's a big light there. It's why I bring a sun to the world. My sun came from my subconsciousness, from my crown. And when he born, I can fix my son, I can solo that related to my soul, that close. All right, so
son, you say son, you're talking
all
about
the idea
Yeshu?
Is to take something that is above consciousness.
You're talking about Yeshua, yeah.
To bring him to consciousness. Now, above the consciousness is the first coming, is Yeshu. It means it's a baby Mashiach. The baby is like something that we have in the heart that is above the brain. Above learning all the rule, all the detail, all the, you know. It's above the university. You know, it's just a hub. And like we said, his root is from the kingdom of the north, so it has to do with more natural behavior.
Approach
to God, more natural. All Hasidut came to reveal this approach that has to do with the 10th Rav, that is to bring more natural, more love, simple Jew, simple prayer to God, to bring this quality to the Judaism, that it become too much brand. This is a Hasidut. This what supposed to make the bridge between Judaism and Christianity. It was the rabbi of Israel, Baal Shem Tov, was Achiyah Shiloni, that he was the founder of the kingdom of the north. All right, so if you belong to the 10th tribe, so it's natural that your way to say God in the name is just natural way to talk to your father or to talk to God. I mean,
yeah.
You know, when you are in a city, in a kingdom, so there are all kind of rule, of kind of bureaucracy that you have to say so, and there you cannot say so, and etc. Right? Because Judaism is like inside the wall. So it's Mashar ben David, it's different mentality. It's vessel and vessel and vessel and vessel. Right, so we must have these two kinds. In the second coming, of course, will be the first coming too. Right, so the first coming is above,
Jesus.
Is Yeshu. It's above the brain. And the second coming has to do with the tree of knowledge, good and evil, what is a fig tree. It's like you write Yeshua with two letters, Ein. Ein, it means ice. With the two ice equal Teena, equal the fig, 456. Also, the second coming has to do with both of them. Yeshu, it means
soul and body.
We need the child. The Jewish needs the inner child too. What you in the New Age they like to talk about the inner child. We need it. The Jewish need it too. They didn't receive him in the first coming because they expect for Mashiach to be something more of an inner child.
Mm-hmm.
Right? They expect.
More than.
They were expecting a king.
They were expecting
Messiah Ben David.
Somebody
to free them from the Romans.
Right,
somebody that teach you Torah is a prophet. So he don't have to teach you Torah. The Torah is hiding in everything he do and everything he said. But it's a prophecy. It means, of course, it's endless Torah hiding there.
I think
why in this place happens so and so, why after this he says this, and why after this he says this. It's all big secret. Why in the place called Cana do the miracle with the wine? What is his mother have to do with the wine, etc.? It's all secret. It's all have a meaning.
I have a question, and that's from what I was studying before Rambam. It was known in ancient Judaism that Mashiach would come twice, once as Mashiach ben Yosef, the suffering servant. And then as Mashiach ben David, the conquering king. But it wasn't until Rambam who he completely changed that. So one man like changed the stream of Judaic thought. Is that true?
It is true that we have in the Jewish tradition two Mashiach, Mashiach ben Yosef. But really the two Mashiach are one.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
The two Mashiach really are one.
Two aspects of the same Messiah.
The same Messiah, yes.
And for him,
soul and body.
For his point of view, he talk about Mashiach of the second coming. For his point of view, he talk about Mashiach ben David, and of course Mashiach ben David is Mashiach ben Yosef as well, because mm-hmm. he will not be Mashiach ben David if he's not receiving the soul of Mashiach ben Yosef.
Because only after you humble yourself will Hashem lift you up. Right? First you have to be humble.
Well, this
come
is...
Come as the servant.
This is one thing, but like we said, it is a Mashiach that has to do with the Torah, what is Mashiach ben David. And it is Mashiach that is more of a prophet, of a something above the Torah, what is Mashiach ben Yosef. Now, originally they are both the same Mashiach. Mm. They just split. It's like one soul split to two, like Adam and Eve split to two. Because it is nothing about baby Jesus that they put it between the donkey and the bull. The donkey is a symbol of Mashiach ben David, and the bull is symbol of Mashiach ben Yosef. So it was both of them. But when it was like Adam and Eve, there was one person, mm. back to back. But must happen a separation so they came face to face and in free choice. The connection has to be, it's like...
Receive the free choice.
Mm-hmm.
Between a man and woman must to be a free choice. Even the original, they are one soul, but they have to grow up in separate place, mm-hmm. in different house, like Judaism and Christianity.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so... When each one of them grow up and get to his maximum as what it, and of what it is, we can do the marriage again. They can be connected again. It's like God separate between the night and the day, and after.
Yeah.
In the beginning, it was all mixed: the darkness and the light.
Chaos.
Mm.
We call it chaos. He make a separation, and then it was evening, it was morning, it's all one day. It's means he make a wedding between both of them. Alright, so all process of rectification is we separate, it's like Jesus
separate.
Said, leave Caesar, leave the money, leave even sex if you can. It means leave this world. I have to do only with spiritual world. It's when you do a complete separation, what is good for the nation is not good for the Jew.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So it's a special thing for the nation because they're too much attached to the physical. So for them, it's good that they completely denied the snake, they denied the bad inclination. No, in Judaism, it's a bad inclusion in holiness, like it can be a holy snake. You can be healed from the snake.
It's hard for the woman to think of anything as a snake is good because he placed enmity in me.
Well, this
but
is...
the word chava, it came from the word chivya, what is a snake.
Oh.
Chivya in Aramaic is the snake, Chivya.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Her original name is Chaya. And Chaya, like we said before, is the name of the beast. But it's the name of the part of the soul that related to what we call Masher Ben David, where starts the connection of with different faces, with different opinions.
Mm-hmm.
It's why, it's what they call in the New Testament the sun and the moon, the two eyes. The sun and the moon represent the day and the night, good and evil, etc.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a righteous man that is responsible on the good and another righteous man that is responsible on the night. The Yeshua with the two eyes stay in Am Yisrael. When Jesus was giving, only Yeshua was giving to the nation, the other Yeshua with two eyes stay in Am Yisrael and split again to two.
You're spelling that Yod, Shin,
Vav,
Ein.
Hmm. So the name of the second coming is Moshe Ben David.
This day in Am Yisrael, this Yeshua, this parallel to another name of Jesus, that if you write Yeshua in symmetry, all my teaching has to do with the word chen, that is a beauty that has to do with symmetry. Yimach he called chen, 58. It's a beauty of symmetry, like Chanukah, chen. Have to do with the number 8. The eight, it's a number that has to do with symmetry. So when he talks about the community of Pergamos, to the winner he will give a white stone.
Mm-hmm.
White stone, even levana, even equal chama, what is the sun. Levana is the way we call the moon. Alright, so if you write Yeshua in symmetry, Yeshua with Ein here, and Yeshua with the same Yud, Yeshua with Ein here.
Like one word?
You have two mm-hmm. Ein. Two Ein equal Chama plus Levana, Sun plus the moon, equal 140, and equal white stone.
Wow!
Right? It is the winner. I will give him a white stone, and on the white stone written a new name, Shem Chadash, equals the letters that are inside. Yeshu with this one Yud.
See why I want to study the Gematria.
Yeah.
Right, I started a little bit.
All right, so you have Yeshu. It's another name that related to the second coming.
Yeshu is the first coming.
Yeshua. But so you have two Ein that equal the white stone, and the letter in the middle equals Shem Chadash, a new name that written on the white stone, that only the receiver knows this name.
Hmm.
Right? So you talk about somebody in the future
mm-hmm.
that knows this name. Right? So it is another Yeshua in symmetry when you put the Ein in the middle. So you write Yeshua. And then, after the Ein, you add Vav, Shin, Yud.
Okay.
This is the first coming. This has to do with these eyes. What is above the two eyes.
It's Yeshua.
Mm-hmm.
This is the first coming. And equal Shabbat. The first coming has to do with the revelation of the Shabbat. The higher revelation of the Shabbat, we call it Rava de Ravim, the will of the will. Rava de Chol Ravim, Rava de Ravim, it's in Aramaic, the will of the will that have to do in Kabbalah to this point, this eyes. All the crown called will. You call this place the will of the will. It's a special revelation that in the third meal of Shabbat we have this revelation, and we call this revelation the coming of Mashiach. This is the first coming of Jesus. Right? So it's like you have two names with seven letters. It's like two lamps. Secret of the two lamps. He talk about two lamps in the New Testament, in the right? Two lamps in seven letters.
The menorah.
Two menorot. One inner and one reveal one.
I wondered about that because in the tabernacle there was one menorah, but in Revelation it talks about the two lampstands, the two menorot. So I wondered about that.
So the two menorot, it's one menorah have to do with this level, and the other menorah have to do with the crown, what is above. The brand starts with the eyes, what we call the brand.
Discernment, duality.
Chochmah plus Bina, what is father and mother, equal 140 as well. Sun plus moon. White stone. Chochmah and Bina is in Kabbalah, it's the way you call the two first name of God.
Wisdom
above
plus
this is
intelligence.
Above this is the crown. We don't, it's not a letter for it. It's above the name of God.
Mm.